that this level of destruction is going to affect larger and larger areas and more people. The horror that you just described, Setsuko, you know, that's what it's going to be like. And you know, when you give this testimony, I've heard you speak a couple of times before, it strikes me that it's just so important for several reasons. One is, you know, listening to the conversation yesterday, especially the comments by some of the states that were talking about general security interests, this conversation is lacking in blood and guts. It's this abstract intellectual game that these people play when they defend nuclear weapons. So this is a chess game that they're playing. And the piece that I think is missing that allows these people to defend the continued existence of these weapons is this: they don't understand what's going to happen. So the message that you bring is enormously important in itself. The other piece, though, that really gets me is this. When I talk to people, I always tell them at the end of my talk, what's going to happen when you leave this room is you're going to start forgetting, start erasing everything that I've told you. It's just too painful to think about. And one of the things that I am so impressed by when I hear you speak, you went through about the worst day that anyone could possibly experience in their life. Something you would normally want to just forget and put out of mind. And you found somehow the strength to revisit that day over and over and over again in order to educate people so we don't have to live through that. In medicine today, there's this big focus on, you know, understanding the molecular basis of everything. So I don't know what the courage molecules in your brain are. Maybe someday we'll figure out what those are, we probably could tell. But absent that, I think we just need to really take great inspiration from your ability to keep this horrible information in mind, because that's what people need to do. The people who are making decisions need to hold on to this stuff. They can't just, I mean, there are people who do know this. I think President Obama, for example, knows this. I think it's just sequestered in some part of his brain that he doesn't access very often. And what we need to figure out is how to make this information available to decision makers so that it's sitting in the part of their brain that guides their action every day. So when they wake up, they think, if I don't work to get rid of nuclear weapons, this is what's going to happen. And other people are going to have to go through and do what they're censored on. And it's just, to me, it's just incredibly inspiring, not just your tale, but your ability to keep telling that tale, which is what we all need to do, so that our part of it.